Well, hello again, everybody. Welcome back to 1908. We go back to the era of all-day games and of no television, no radio coverage, nothing but newspaper coverage and what you can get if you can manage to make it over to the ballpark in time. And we have another one of these afternoon games, as were all the games, at least during the week back in those days, between the Browns and the Red Sox. Browns at 19-13, Red Sox at 18-15. And they're fighting for supremacy near the top. The Browns in second place, a game behind Cleveland. Red Sox 2.5 games behind, and if they lose again here, they're probably going to be out of contention for at least the next little while. It will be Hope Ferris here for the Browns leading this off against Eddie Cicotte. Ferris rolls a 34 for a 44. There is a little E roll. It's a 64 out of the range. That means it's a fly ball to center. Sullivan has that, and that's the first out, one away. Here's Jimmy Williams. Now, Williams is hitting 248. Cicotte, by the way, 4-2 is his record, 2.88 ERA. And the roll is a 36 for a 33. There's a little pop-up over to second. It'll be McConnell grabbing that, two away. Up is George Stone. You can imagine Cicotte throwing those knuckleballs, right? That's what you think about when you think of Cicotte. Not so much 1919 as much as the knuckler. Stone rolls a 12 for a 25, ground ball to second, and it'll be McConnell throwing to first. We go to the bottom of the first inning. Doc Gessler there against Harry Howell. Howell, clearly the ace of the Brown staff, 4-1 his record, 2.13 ERA. Struck out 19, walked 18. Rolls a 63 for a 31, fly ball center field. It'll be Hoffman getting that for the one away. Ambie McConnell now. He rolls a 13 for a 14 and takes his walk. So now it's 19 walks, 19 strikeouts for Howell, and up comes Bob Unglaub. Hitting 295 is Bob. McConnell does have an 11, so we will do some running. Here's the hit and run. It rolls a 33 for a 7, and that's a single to right field and sends McConnell over to third, and that'll bring up Denny Sullivan. And the fans here in Boston start to whoop it up at the old Huntington Avenue grounds. And Sullivan comes up, and the question is, do you pull the infield in or not? I think we leave it deep this early in the game. And he rolls a 33 again for a 7. That's the fly ball to center, and Hoffman's got that for the out, but the runner scores. It's 1-0 Boston. Up is Gavi Kravath with the runner on at first base. Two outs, bottom of the first, 1-0. Gavi rolls a 66 for a 0. A lot of good rolls here for the Red Sox. And it's a 61 for a 2. It's a triple down the right field foul line past Jones's reach, and it took a while for Hartzell to get there, and that'll bring up Heinie Wagner. 2-0 now, Red Sox. Wagner comes up hitting 264. He does have 12 men driven in. And he rolls a 21 for a 30. Fly ball to left. Stone has that for the out. We go to the top of the second. It'll be Jim Stevens here for the Browns. Rolls a 21 for a 30. Fly ball to left field. Kravath has that, one away. Here's Roy Hartzell. Roy rolls a 25 for an 11. That'll be a single. Then he steals second. And that brings up Danny Hoffman. Runner on at second base. One out, top of the second. Roll is a 43 for a 29. Ground ball, first base. Unglaub flips over to Cicotte for the out, and Hartzell moves to third. So two away, here's Tom Jones. And he rolls a 61 for a 41, change to 39. That's going to be a fly ball to center field. Easy for Sullivan, and he makes the catch. We go to the bottom of the second inning. I guess that since it was a 39, should be an unusual play, but fly ball to center is a fly ball to center in my book. Here's Harry Lord. Harry rolls a 14 for a 43. It's a fly ball to left, and Stone has that. One gone. Here's Lou Krieger now for the Red Sox. And Lou rolls a 33 for a 7. Single to right, that's the third 33 that the Red Sox have rolled this game. Not that I'm keeping track, but you know what I'm saying. Up comes Cicotte. You know he's going to bunt. His roll is a 12 for a 24. It's a poor bunt. It's back to Howell. He throws, turns around and throws to Wallace covering a second. They get the lead runner. That'll bring up Gessler with two men out. Cicotte doesn't have one. He always got to look. Maybe he has an 11. No, he doesn't. Rolls a 63 for a 31. See, if it was a hit and run, that would have been a base hit, but we're not going to do that if he doesn't have the 11. It's a fly ball to Hoffman, and he's got that for the out. We go to the top of the third. 2-0 now, Boston. And here's Bobby Wallace. Wallace rolls a 65 for a 35. There's a little E roll. It's a 36 out of the range. That'll be a pop-up left side. Lord has that for the out, one away. Here's Harry Howell. And Howell rolls an 11 for a 6. That'll be a clean double to right center. And he's in there with second base, and that's a little unusual for the pitcher. Second hit of the game for the Browns. That brings up Hope Ferris. And see, when you don't have many runs or many hits, every hit counts. And when the pitcher gets a hit, you kind of turn your head a little bit. Ferris rolls a 55 for an A, that's a single over second. That'll score the pitcher, and Harry Ferris is at safe at first base with that single. It's 2-1. Here now is Jimmy Williams. So Cicotte's had some knucklers that didn't quite knuckle quite right, and here's Williams. Rolls a 56 for a 34. It's a pop-up over to short. Wagner's got that for the out, two away. Up is George Stone. George Stone up there hitting 287 has been having a good season for the Browns, as they've been surprisingly in contention. The Browns have not been much of a team the last couple years. And the rolls a 54 for a 45. It's a fly ball to Sullivan in center. He's got that one for the out. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Ammy McConnell up here for the Red Sox hitting 280. McConnell, one of those guys with a first name that you love to say and it's easy to remember, and he rolls a 66 for a 0. He rewards me for the compliment, and it's a 23 for a 6. That'll be a double to right center field, and Hal just doesn't have it today. It's hit number 4 for the Red Sox, and it feels like they've all been for power. Here comes Unglau. He rolls a 24 for a 13 and strikes out. So Harry Howell with his first strikeout of the game against the one walk. And here's Denny Sullivan, one out, bottom of the third. Rolls a 41 for a 28, ground ball to short. Wallace throws to first, two away, and McConnell has to stay at second with that play in front of him. Two away, and here's Gavi Kravitz, who's hitting 211 but with 14 RBIs. He rolls a 54 for a 45. There is a little E-roll. And it's going to be a 34 out of the range, so that's a fly ball to center. Hoffman's got that for the out. We go to the top of the fourth, still 2-1 Red Sox. And first up is Jim Stevens. Stevens is hitting 267. He's 0-1. Stevens rolls a 62 for a 12. There is a little E-roll. It's a 26 just outside the range. Ground ball, first base side. Unglaub has it, goes to the bag, one away. Roy Hartzell next. He rolls a 61 for a 30. It's a fly ball to left. Kravitz has that, two away. And here's Danny Hofman. 16 is the roll. 28 is the result, as usual. Ground ball to short. Wagner to first. And we go to the bottom of the fourth. And here is Heine Wagner. He's not quite as proficient as the other Wagner, hitting 262. So he's about 100 points off of that mark. But he still gets it done. Rolls a 52 for a 27. Ground ball to third. And Ferris fields it and throws to first. There's one away. Harry Lord is up next. Lord rolls a 16 for a 26. That'll be a ground ball to second. Williams throws to first. Two gone. And here's Lou Krieger. Krieger rolls a 55 for an 8. That's a grounder to short. And Wallace has it, throwing to first. We go to the top of the fifth inning. It'll be Tom Jones. Tom Jones will lead this off. Rolls a 35 for a 37. That's a strike. His next roll, 32 for a 26. Ground ball to second. McConnell has that on to first. One away. Bobby Wallace comes up next. Bobby rolls a 16 for a 26. Ground ball now to second. McConnell has that on to first, and there's two away. Here comes the pitcher, Harry Howell. 1-for-1 today with that double, hitting now 222. And the roll's a 13 for a 13, and he strikes out. We go to the bottom of the fifth inning, still 2-1 Red Sox. Close game, tight game. We'll see if it stays tight. Here's Eddie Cicotte, who's 0-for-1, got out on the fielder's choice, hitting 200. So good hitting pitchers here today. Cicotte rolls a 62 for a 12. It's a ground ball over to Jones, who steps in the bag himself, one away. This is back in the days when pitchers could make contact, at least some of them could. GoXLR up next rolls a 36 for a 14. He'll take his base on the walk. Howell now has struck out one, walk two. That brings up McConnell. GoXLR is slow, but he has an 11. You might wonder, well, how is that the case? Well, the S and F rating is sort of a run index. I've explained this, I think, before. Guys who didn't score as many runs as expected ended up with an S, and the ones who did more than expected get an F. But that has nothing to do with stealing the bases. You can think of base stealing as different from raw speed. So we're going to do a hit and run. The roll's at 23 for a 32 as my dog goes nuts. Fly ball to right field, and it'll be Hartzell grabbing that for the out, two away. And here's Bob Unglaub. Unglaub rolls a 65 for a 35. It's a pop-up to the catcher, Stevens, and we go to the top of the sixth. Still 2-1 Red Sox. Close game. Here's Hope Ferris. Hope rolls a 44 for a 7. That'll be a single to right field in front of GoXLR, and that'll bring up Jimmy Williams. And so the Browns now have the leadoff batter on yet again. Williams comes up, and the question is, well, you can't really do a hit and run. Ferris is not fast enough, so we're going to bunt, I think, with Jimmy hitting 244, and the roll is a 21 for a 30. It's a good bunt to the left side. Lord fields it and throws over to, there he is, Ambie McConnell covering at the bag. Ferris moves up to second. So there's one out. Here comes George Stone. Stone rolls a 14 for a 13. It's a fly ball over to left field. Kravitz has that for the out, two away, and up is Jim Stevens. Stevens is driven in only 7 runs, but he's hitting 263, and he's got a little bit of power. That's why he's hitting up so high. And his roll is a 65 for a 35. There is a little E roll. And the little E roll is an 11, so it's within the range. That's going to be an error charge to the shortstop, Wagner, and he boots that one. Ferris and Stevens both save. First error of the ball game. That'll bring up Roy Hartzell. So runners on the corners, two outs, top of the six. Here's Roy Hartzell. He rolls a 62 for a 12. That's going to be a little ground ball over to first. Dunglaub has it, flips over to Cicotte, and we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. 2-1 Red Sox, and they're making it close. And up is Denny Sullivan, and Boston's hoping for at least one more run. Sullivan rolls a 31 for a 9. It's a pop-up left side. It'll be Ferris making the catch. One away. Gavi Kravath now. He rolls a 23 for a 32. Fly ball to right, and Hartzell's got that. Two away. Here's Heine Wagner. Wagner rolls a 22 for an 8. There's a single to left center field. That'll bring up Harry Lord. And with the runner on at first, Wagner, of course, can fly. And the roll is a 42 for a 22, and Lord is hit by that pitch, and we have runners on at first and second now for Lou Krieger. 2-1 ball game, bottom of the sixth. Two outs, however, so we'll see what Krieger can do. He's hitting 243. And he rolls a 45 for a 14, and what an inopportune time to give up your third walk of the ball game. That loads the bases now. Now, Eddie Cicotte is up. He's not necessarily a power hitter, but he does have the ability to do stuff to you. He has driven in a run already this year. And he rolls a 15 for an 8. What did I tell you? It's a single through short, and that will advance that will score two. Runner on third base. Krieger is thrown out trying to go to third, but Cicotte gets it done with the single, and it's now 4-1 Red Sox. We go to the top of the seventh inning. So the Red Sox are showing their seriousness and earnestness in trying to get to the back into this pennant race. And here's Danny Hoffman. Danny rolls a 64 for a 13, strikes out, one away. Here's Tom Jones. Two strikeouts for Cicotte. Knuckler working well. He's got 26 this season. Jones rolls a 54 for a 45. There's a little E. It's a 16, which is within the range. That's a ground ball over to Wagner, who boots it. Second error of the game. Both of them on Wagner, by the way. That'll bring up Bobby Wallace. So Red Sox in double play formation. And the roll 55 for an 8. That's a single to center field. And it drops in front of Sullivan, and that'll put runners on at first and second. Here now, Harry Howell. And now is the time where we think a little bit about strategy. Howell probably not going to do much with the bat, so we're going to have him bunt, though he does have a double today. He rolls a 42 for a 13, so he bunts that one foul. 0-1. Next roll is a 55 for an 8. It's a good bunt back to Cicotte, who throws over to McConnell covering at first. Runners both move up, and now with two outs, here's Hope Ferris. Hope is 2-for-3 with two singles, hitting 324, and is a big part of the reason why the Browns are where they are. He rolls a 63 for a 31. It's a fly ball to Sullivan in center, and that does it. We go to the bottom of the seventh inning. Doc Gessler leads this off for the Red Sox. Gessler's 0-for-2, did walk once, hitting 331, and the Browns are running out of time. Doc rolls a 23 for a 29. Come back over to Howell, who throws to first, one away. Amby McConnell up there now. He rolls a 66 for a 0. It's a 53 for a 6. That'll be a double to right center field, and up comes Bob Unglaub. And the Red Sox, with a key base hit here, could put this one out of reach. Bob rolls a 12 for a 25. There is a little E roll, however. It's a 15. That's in the range, and so that will be a fly ball over to right field, dropped by Hartzell, and the runner scores, and it's now 5-1. That brings up Denny Sullivan. So first error of the game on the Browns, and here is Sullivan with Unglaub on it first. He's rolled a 42 for a 13. That's a strikeout. There's two away. Gavi Kravath now. And so Howell struck out two, walked threes, 21-21 on the season in those terms. Kravath rolls a 46 for a 29. Come back over to Howell, who throws over to first base for the out. And we go to the top of the eighth inning. Jimmy Williams will lead this off. Browns having their own defensive miscues, and as this game grows darker, it's going to be a little bit harder for them. Williams rolls a 36 for a 33. There is a little E-roll. It's a 42, and it's going to be a pop-up to second. McConnell's got that for the out, one away. Here's George Stone. He rolls a 32 for a 26, ground ball to second. McConnell throws to first, two away. Here's now Jim Stevens. And Jim rolls a 23 for a 32, fly ball to right. Gessler's got that for the out. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. It'll be Heine Wagner to lead this off. Heine rolls a 22 for an 8. It's a single to left center field. 8 hits here for the Red Sox. I've said this before. I'll say it again. You would think that nobody gets a base hit in 1908. Just not true. You get a lot of games with 8, 9, 10, 11 hits, right? It's just the teams that don't get them. That's what stands out. Here's Harry Lord. And do a little hit and run. The roll is a 45 for a 14. Wagner has that base stolen. Lord's still up there with a ball on him now. And he rolls a 31 for a 9. So it's a ground ball over to first. Jones has it, goes to the bag himself. Wagner goes up to third. And all the noise is coming now. Here's Lou Krieger with one out, bottom of the eighth. Rolls a 13 for a 38, change to a 39. That's a fly ball center field. And Hoffman has it for the out, but the runner tags and scores. Two away, and it's 6-1 Red Sox. Here's the pitcher, Eddie Cicotte. He rolls a 21 for a 13 and strikes out. We go to the top of the ninth inning. 6-1 Red Sox. Cicotte going for that complete game. First man in his way is Roy Hartzell. He rolls a 45 for a 14, and Eddie's given up his first walk of the game. That'll bring up Danny Hoffman, but it's probably too little too late. Danny rolls a 64 for a 13 and strikes out. One away. It's Tom Jones. Rolls a 35 for a 37. That's going to be a runner cut off first by Cicotte. Good throw to first. Good tag by Unglaub. So two away, and here is Jones still. And he rolls a 21 for a 30. Fly ball left field. Kravitz has got that for the out, and that'll do it. So the final score here, Red Sox 6, Browns 1. And there's your ball game. The Red Sox advanced just a little bit. I think they're tied now with St. Louis for either second or third place in the American League, and it's getting tighter and tighter. Red Sox win this one. It was close at first, but didn't stay that way for long. Hope you enjoyed it. Talk to you later. Bye.